Hi Suzuki friends! Today we're going to paint our own poppy flowers inspired by Georgia O'Keeffe's famous painting called Poppy. As you can see in the book we read together, she's holding a poppy on the front cover. The petals are orange and red, and the pistil and the stamens are black. So we're going to use the colors black, red, orange, and yellow, because some poppy flowers also have the color yellow. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to get our white piece of paper and we're going to paint some of our colors onto the paper to make our petals. Ready? Now you're going to make large strokes away from it, all the way around your paper. And as you're painting, you can turn your paper the other way. And I can paint away from you again. Let's use a little more red, and then we're going to switch to a new color. Okay. Let's rinse our brush. Let's use orange. Now we're going to go right on top of our red paint and blend those colors together. Keep painting away from me, friends. Now we can turn our paper around. And let's paint the other half. And a big strokes away from you. See if you can color your whole paper. Next, let's rinse our color. And let's use a little bit of yellow. I'm going to paint away from you. Okay. Let's rinse our brush and put it down. Now this is what my poppy looks like. What does yours look like? Next, we're going to get our black strip paper and we're going to cut little pieces and put them right in the middle to make our stamen and our pistil. Can you cut with me? Hold your scissors this way and hold one strip paper in the other. Cut, 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 and cut. Now, our paper is still wet, right, friends? So we can take our black pieces of paper and put them right on top without using any glue. See if you can put them right in the middle. Press down so they'll stick. Put them right in the middle. Just like Georgia O'Keeffe's flower. Now, the next step we're going to do is we're going to cut around the edges of our paper to make a round circular flower. So we're going to go all the way around. Now friends, if you'd like for your paint to dry first, you can do that and then cut. I'm going to show you while it's still wet. Pick up our scissors. Very carefully cut around the edge. Let's keep going. Remember, you want to hold your scissors up nice and straight. Let's cut the next side. One more side to go. Now you have your own poppy flower. Put it in a safe place so it can dry, and then you can hang up your masterpiece. I hope you had fun making art today with me, friends. Have a great day.